Could you explain what a T cell is?
It's a white blood cell. They're white blood cells that go through processing in the thymus up in the neck, particularly when we're very young, and then they form lineages and they circulate in the blood. And what they do is they search and destroy for abnormal cells. If you think of the immune response, they're very specific, just as specific as the antibodies we normally think about with immunity, which attach, which are individual molecules secreted by cells that attach to folded parts of proteins and block interactions. The T cells are programmed to target onto cells that are modified in some way. They could be modified by cancer that causes changes in the cells, or they could be modified by an infection. And in an infection, it's little bits of the virus that get put onto the cell surface in molecules we call the transplantation proteins and the major histocompatibility molecules, just another word. And so basically what the T cells are about is looking at the surface of our cells, see if they're abnormal. You could call it surveillance of self, if you like. And then they're programmed, the ones that I'd worked on, which are the killer cells, are programmed to turn on and kill that cell, which, as if it's a virus infection, the virus has to grow in living cells. So you're killing the virus producing factory. If it's a cancer cell, then you're getting rid of the cancer.
And how do killer T cells manage to recognize and destroy those infected cells?
Because they ignore the normal cells, that the transplant molecules on the surface of those cells look quite normal. They've seen them before. They've learned not to attack them when they're differentiating through the thymus. It's what we call tolerance. But when that molecule is modified by just having a little bit of protein, 8 or 10 amino acids from protein stuck in its tip, it looks totally different. And it looks as different as, say, when you give an organ from someone else, a kidney or a liver, and the kidney or liver is rejected. That cell now looks as different as that foreign kidney.
What are some of the most exciting applications of your work on killer T cells?
Well, it's half the immune system. The immune system we normally prime up with vaccination is the antibody response. We prime up what we call the B cell compartment, which are cells that differentiate to big protein secreting cells called plasma cells and produce these very, very specific antibody or immunoglobulin molecules. And they're the ones that will, say, block the virus from getting into the cell in the first place. So that's the ideal protection. But once the virus is in, we have to get rid of that cell and the virus, and that's what the killer T cells do. So the applications are, you can immunize for these in vaccination. It's a response that comes up later than the antibody response. There is an application in cancer that won the Nobel Prize several years back for Jim Allison and Tosuku Honjo, where these cells are sitting in cancer, but they've been turned off, and you can give them monoclonal antibodies, which will turn them back on again. And this has been a remarkably successful treatment for some forms of cancer, particularly melanoma. So that's a major breakthrough. But it's also the same principle in these cells which underlies a lot of our autoimmune diseases, where they're actually turning on to recognize some of our own self proteins. So basically, there's two halves to it. There's this very effect of eliminating cancer cells, eliminating virus-infected cells, some bacterial infected cells. But on the other hand, there's a risk that they can abnormally turn on and start to attack our own cells. And that's what happens in probably rheumatoid arthritis and multiple sclerosis.